Welcome to Gerard McLennan Live. Burr Oak Cemetery has the spotlight now, but should the floods and cameras had been on these cemeteries months and years ago to prevent illegal exhuming and dismemberment? Mount Glenwood is on blast now as a human bone has been found in that cemetery. Although the crimes are unthinkable and horrible, should we do as Maurice Daly's wife demands? She says, quote, "What happened to innocent till proven guilty?" she asked. Give your life to Christ, she says. How about that? She also continues by saying, what happened to mercy when he died on the cross for everybody? What about that? End quote. She may be right, but if she could see her own loved ones' graves being desecrated, would she forgive the perpetrators? We must remember that you can be forgiven, yet still get punished for your transgressions. Joining us now from the Tribune Tower is surveillance expert, the president of YouSpyStore.com, Mr. Perry Myers. Mr. Myers, how are you this evening?
Great. How are you? Thank you.
You know, I'm doing fantastic. Unfortunate circumstances at Burr Oak Cemetery over, you know, the 4 to 5 year period here. It seems as if it's an inside job. Of course, all of the suspects, this is alleged right now. But what I want to get to is two things today. I want to look at forgiveness later in the show, but right now, should cemeteries have surveillance? Let's discuss the monitoring of a huge landmass. Before we do that, let's hear a little bit about you, Mr. Myers, your background.
Okay, I've been a private investigator for nearly 30 years, and in 2001, we took over the YouSpy store, which is surveillance equipment, which you can buy online or one of our 4 stores. And we specialize in these kind of things. Now, it is a big proposition to do video surveillance on an entire cemetery, but most of the time you've got entrance and exits that you could perhaps focus on. Now, yeah, if it's inside, that makes it a little more difficult because, you know, the people are going to be in there who are in there, and they're supposed to be in there. Yeah. But there are also ways of setting up surveillance, and, you know, obviously there's going to be more details which will help figure out exactly what we might do.
Yeah, absolutely. It's a huge landmass. You know, cemeteries, you know, there are some that are relatively small, but then you have some plots that are huge. I mean, acres and acres of land. Let's get into some specifics. How would a company like yours, what type of products would you use, and how would you be specific in monitoring a landmass like a cemetery?
Well, it really is going to depend, and you have to figure out a budget. But some of the products we might use, obviously you're going to use infrared because cemeteries typically are dark at night. And if these people are using little or no light, you want to be able to illuminate the area. You also probably want some type of auto tracking or auto detection camera, which there are on the market.
Yeah.
You cover a larger area, and the camera actually detects and will zoom in on any kind of motion. You definitely want to get the entrances with like a good license plate camera that will monitor the area, who's coming, who's going, and get a good shot of the license plate in case it is an outsider.
Yeah. Now, when we talk about thermal or heat sensing and motion sensing, it's pretty obvious what the difference is, but are there advantages one over the other?
Well, thermal will pick up a human image in any kind of light. It doesn't need light. It picks up the thermal heat from the body.
Mm.
They are pricey. I mean, the cameras are going to be in the $50,000 range. But you know, that may not be necessary because if you could do an infrared low light camera and you could light up the area with infrared light, so it wouldn't look lit up to the naked eye, but it would be lit up for the cameras.
Well, I tell you what, Perry Myers and Gerard McLendon tonight, we are going to declare a motion, my friend. We're going to call it the Cemetery Surveillance Act. I mean, let's face it. I know that this is your business, but do you not agree with me? Should cemeteries be monitored?
Well, there should be some kind of monitoring effort on behalf of the cemeteries, especially when this kind of thing happens. I mean, obviously cameras isn't the only answer. If you did like a foot surveillance, which could be costly and time consuming, and you could see what's been dug up and what shouldn't be dug up. I mean, I was thinking about it as an investigator. If you had someone walking the cemetery each day and say, hey, why is this dirt uncovered?
Yeah.
You know?
And for years, people, families of loved ones were upset because they saw land that was, you know, moved. They saw dirt up. They saw empty graves, and everything was falling on ears that weren't to be heard. They were like, well, forget about it. But we found out, Mr. Myers, that the office manager may have been involved with this. She was one of the alleged people doing this. You know, give me a final word, Mr. Myers, pertaining to if cameras are on cemeteries, can these be routed directly to police stations?
Well, usually not. The police aren't going to monitor that, but they'll go to a place and you're going to have sufficient storage where you're going to be able to go back months or even years if you want. Hard drives are cheap these days, so you could really store this up. And, you know, if you need to go back and find out what happened last year, you should be able to do that.
Yeah, yeah. Perry Myers, the one and only. He's from You Spy Store. You can hit him at YouSpyStore.com. We appreciate you being on Gerard McClendon Live tonight, my friend.
Thank you for inviting me.
All right, take care now.
You too, thanks.
Bur Oak Cemetery, the family speak out before Congress today at the Dirksen Center. Should cemeteries be under 24-hour surveillance? Should the perpetrators be forgiven? Give me a call tonight, 630-575-TALK. Gerard McClendon Live. I'll be back in 2 minutes.